to celebrate our first Holy Communion with us. We are glad that you all are all here. Just as we have dressed in special clothes, we have specially prepared our hearts to receive the body and blood of Jesus for the first time. As we begin our celebration, you can show your support by joining us in the singing and responses of the liturgy. We want to thank parents, grandparents, godparents, teachers, relatives, and friends for all that you have done to help us get this far in our Catholic faith. May God bless you all.
Please join us for our opening hymn, number 544, Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee.
God keep them growing in his faith and grace. God's blessings upon this help shepherd. Help us to follow our baptism. Renew the baptism within us and bless this water in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. May Almighty God have mercy on us and through the celebrating of this Eucharist make us worthy to sit in this heavenly banquet when we came from heaven. And everybody says, Amen. Amen.
Almighty ever living God, lead us to share in the joys of heaven
so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. There are some special readings today, of course, but we always expect to read from the Acts of the Apostles. We have Peter, this is after Jesus rose from the dead and sent the Holy Spirit. We have St. Peter healed a crippled man in the name of Jesus. He said, now that the power is, you know, in the name of Jesus. And we hear what they say, what are we going to do? God does miracles. What are we going to do? And this is what St. Peter says. And then the second reading, it says that we're all children of God and we're going to see him as he is. And then the gospel talks about the good shepherd. The good shepherd loves us and cares for us and protects us. And of course, that's Jesus. Let's open our ears and hearts to hear.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said, "Leaders of the people and elders, if we are being examined today about a good deed done to a cripple, namely, by what means he was saved, then all of you and all the people of Israel should know that it was in the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead. In his name, this man stands before you healed. He is the stone rejected by you, the builders, which has become the cornerstone. There is no salvation through anyone else, nor is there any other name under heaven given to the human race by which we are to be saved." The word of the Lord. Thank you. reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet, so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father, I will lay down my life for my sheep. I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. These also I must lead. They will hear my voice, and there will be one flock, one shepherd. This is why the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it from me. I lay it down on my own, so I can take it up again. I have power to lay it down, power to take it up again. The command I received from my Father. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Got all kinds of things here.
special day for communion. Come on, are you excited? I'm excited.
Not nervous. I think it's okay. You know, practice harder, things can go good. Now we just don't worry. Everything's gonna be good. Just enjoy. So that'll be good. Before I forget, there are two collections. One's for the Good Shepherd collection. The second one is for a retired priest of the diocese of New York. So just before I forget, that's where you have two baskets. How can we work on that? But, you know, if we're working, what can we practice and get ready and study and learning and what can your retreat where you learn about the Last Supper and the Passover and how here we are. We can Jesus talk about Good Shepherd. Before we get into the Good Shepherd, I'm reading, first of all, to you that we're all children of God. And the second reading, I think that's pretty neat. If you're 90 years old, you're still a child of God. How about that? And if you're a priest, you're still a child of God. If you're a great grandmother, you're still a child of God. If you're a dad, you're still a child of God. If you're a mom, you're, and I give you all I know. If you're a third grader. But what does that mean? You know, because he made us, right? And he's the real father. But he says only in Jesus, because he's the only son of God, right? He died for us, and now we are our children. You know, because of Jesus. Jesus is, we're brothers with Jesus. He saved us. So we can all think about that. What does it mean to be a child of God? It's like having a mom and a dad that are the greatest and the best, and they can help you out the most and love you the most. And again, even if you're 90 years old. So that's pretty cool. So that was around today in the library of the church there. And let's see. I was looking through some pictures. I know you guys are older than this, but we're all, again, we're all children of God. Look at this. Jesus with the children. He held them and took care of them and loved them and all of that stuff. Okay? Look at that. Jesus and the children. How about that? Wish I could talk like that. See, he's smiling. He's happy. And they're all hugging himself. Wouldn't you like to have Jesus like that? I'd like to have Jesus like that. And it says here that Jesus welcomes the children and showed everyone how much he loved them. He took them in his arms. He held them close to him. He spoke kindly to them. He gave them love. Why not do you think about Jesus like that? And we do. The mothers and the children were so happy when they went back to their homes and they knew that Jesus is the friend of little children. Isn't that neat? So he loves you especially. Again, you're big children. You know, all of us, we're all little kids in God's eyes. So that's that. And so, the next thing we heard about, right, that we talked about, is the Good Shepherd. And I found one here, a shepherd and sheep. Look, shepherd and sheep. That's what it was like to see. Okay. I'm sure you've seen pictures of sheep and shepherds that they hold in the cold days. That's what they look like, right? That's where you go, you know, to Holy Land still, places like Jordan, Middle East, and things like that. They actually still have shepherds that they kind of look like that. And, you know, and and we got one more show and tell. Who wants to come and take to see what's in here from the first community class? Anybody? Okay, Cruz, come on up here, the first one to raise your hand. Let's see what we got in this room right in here. Oh, turn around so people can see. All right.
What's the first thing?
chickens and two dogs. Dogs, all their burgers. Okay, well, you know, we care and love God as you guys care for your sheep. So does God love care like that? You know, so much and thank you for your in. So you love him. You know, you don't want anything bad to happen to you, do you? So, right, you want to be bad to your animals, Leo. Okay, well, good. All right, so God doesn't want to do that for you either. You're like his sheep. You know, he cares for you like in every way. The one thing that is the first thing we need to think about that. Stay there. Don't move. Or I can say it like that. Is if you didn't feed your ducks or chickens or your other animals, your birds or your cats or your fish, what would happen?
They would die,
huh? Well, you know, so can you learn all about this and, you know, you already know Jesus, right? You were baptized and prayed to Jesus and you received his forgiveness and first reconciliation. So you know who Jesus is, right? Okay. And, you know, one thing about today is, again, today you receive Jesus in communion. It's a different receiving Jesus. But the thing about it is, it's the food, the spiritual food. And we need spiritual food just like we need this. Physically, we need something from Jesus all the time. And so this is, again, we like meat. We're told every week, go to Mass, go receive communion. Because what happens then is like that food. You know, we eat food. I know we eat right before it. Like, I eat breakfast, but I don't sometimes, you know, it's not like, it's like toast and cereal and stuff. And you know, you feel good, but then after about a while later, you know, before prayer, about 2 hours later, it's like, I need something else, I need something different. And I eat them, got energy again. At the same time, I'm around dinner time, like, man, I'm tired, man. Like, and then eat something, and like, okay, yeah, I'm ready to go again. Well, communion's like that with God, you know, like, by the time Friday comes along, it's like, spiritually, you know, you're losing your energy, and you go to communion, I got Jesus again, you know, and for me it's every day, why is this a day, it's like, when am I going to get Jesus in communion, and you know, you don't even know, and you think, I said, what's wrong with me, I didn't go to communion, what's wrong with me, I didn't pray, and that's spiritual food, you know, and so keep working on it, so make it really important to you, you know, this day, again, you got Jesus, you know Jesus, and he's going to be with you like that, but then, I'm going to keep going, something's not right, I got to get communion, I got to get Jesus, so we pray that God keeps helping us and keeps helping us grow, and so we don't die spiritually, but we keep getting stronger spiritually, and everybody says, amen. We profess our faith. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of the Father. Through him all things were made. For us to end our salvation and came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, he was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became a man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, suffered death and was buried, rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom he will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, proceeding from the Father and the Son. The Father and the Son is adored and glorified, is spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, apostolic church. I confess my baptism for forgiveness of sins.
I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. St. Mark. I'm trying to find it here. Just hang on. We're getting close because today's St. Mark's feast day. All right.
Oh God, you raised up St. Mark, your evangelist, and endowed him with the grace to preach the gospel. Grant, we pray, that we may so profit from his teaching as to fulfill faithfully in the footsteps of Christ. Follow Jesus like St. Mark, who lives and reigns you in the Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Pray my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, that we are renewed constantly at work within us, because God's always in us, changing us and helping us and getting closer to Him, that we can have great unending joy through Christ Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart.
We lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty, our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But on this day above laud you more gloriously, when Christ became our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he's destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. Even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as we acclaim. Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread and, giving you thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving you thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Thank you.
death and his resurrection, and looking forward to his coming again. We partake in the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. We offer you the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Jesus, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring them to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Lawrence, our Bishop, Bishop Donald, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who have died in your mercy. Now let's stop and close our eyes and bow our heads. Pray for people who have died, that we know that God takes them to heaven. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. With the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Saint Mark, with the blessed apostles, all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty, Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, may we always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and power and glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live and you who reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of our Lord Jesus be with all of you.
You take away your sins, O Lord.
sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, okay, so all use hand sanitizer, sanitize your hands, single file, 6 feet apart. If you have been to confession, you want to come up for a blessing, please do. Or if you're not of the Catholic faith, please come up. We'll give you a blessing. Just put your hand on your heart like this if you're not going to communion. That will remind you to give a blessing. Please wear masks coming up as well. Thank you. First communicants, of course, will go first at the altar service, and I'll do the people in the handicapped queue and then to the communion. That way, I won't forget.
Okay, remember, we received Jesus, now we're all one with Jesus too in communion. I just thought just a little bit of quiet time, close our eyes, bow our heads, and just pray that we're one in Jesus and Jesus lives in us forever in the Holy Communion. Shepherd, be pleased to settle in eternal pastures us, the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of Jesus, your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Okay, let's give our first communion kids a round of applause and congratulations. Are done until next fall, and we've been getting kind of breaking into coming to the family masses. Now we don't have family masses, guess what you got to do? Sunday morning or Saturday night, Saturday at 5 or Sunday at 9, right? We want to see you, especially next Sunday. Can you promise me?
Yeah.
Okay, so Wednesday there will be a holy hour at 6 o'clock, but the confessions will not be confession. Father Jeff and I are going out to dinner for our anniversary, so we'll have a holy hour, but you won't have me. Thursday, pastoral council at 4:30 p.m. The Lord be with you. God's blessings upon you. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
From our class and parish, we are so blessed to have you.
Those are tall.